You are like this cult thing. Like even David at 21, I'm like, he's like, I love Drake and Josh. I'm like, that was on when I was a kid. Like, how do you know that? Maybe it's reruns?
Yeah, reruns.
That you get no money from.
Thanks, Nickelodeon.
Now you're doing eating shows. You gonna do an intro?
Welcome guys. This is my first ever mukbang with the queen of YouTube.
Of eating, anyways.
Of eating, of living their full life, flourishing, really, thriving. I'm Miss Trisha Payne.
Ah, I'm so excited. I'm most excited to do this mukbang with you because like I feel like you know you used to be an eater, so I feel like you would appreciate this.
100%.
A lot of people don't. Like I do it with people and they're like, you know, like, they just like take a bite and then put it down. So I feel like this is gonna be.
Who does that? Who would do that?
I don't understand it. What I say is eat whatever and get liposuction. Like I'm gonna get another round of liposuction this summer, so I'm just trying to pack it all in.
Are you?
Get the butt lift again because I had liposuction twice.
Okay.
And so I get smaller each time, but then I gain a little back and then I put it in the butt and then you know what
happens.
I mean? Liposuction.
I get it.
Yeah.
Maybe we get a group rate. You know? Can we give a shout out, Doctor Whoever, and we'll get hooked up?
Yeah, actually, there is a doctor that hooks people up for like a shout out.
Great.
I kind of want to do it. Yeah.
I'm so tempted.
I just love to eat. You know, I love eating and I love just getting the fat sucked out of me after.
Yeah, why not? I'm down. Look, get a little tune-up. Don't have any fears about getting a little plastic surgery. You deserve it. You know what I mean? Any teen, baby.
Do you not hate that, though, because you lost weight naturally? Do you hate when people, like, cheat?
No, I have no problem. I had a little plastic surgery after I lost the weight.
After, though.
Yeah, I had a little good housekeeping. A little extra skin removed. Why not?
I love that. That's so hot.
But, yeah, I did it naturally. A lot of people sometimes won't believe me. Like, when I say I lost 100 pounds, they'll be like, oh, like, so you had the sleeve or the surgery. And I'm like, no, just natural. They're like, okay.
Really? They don't believe it. Because you're Hollywood. That's why Hollywood people like the quick, fast route. Right. You know what I mean?
They're like, you're not strong.
That's me, though. If I lost any amount of weight, I definitely... Because you can get the sleeve even if you want to lose, like, 50 pounds.
Really?
I thought about getting it. Yeah, well, a friend of mine, his mom got it. And she, like, literally looks so good. But then I'm like, the problem with me isn't that I don't... It's like, I know when I'm full, I just keep eating. So I feel like even if I have that, I'll like feel full, but I'll still want to keep eating.
Eat through it.
Yeah.
But then you get sick.
But I do that anyways. Like I get sick every night. I like overeat every night.
No.
Yeah, I like eat and I'm like, oh, but I'm gonna start a diet tomorrow. So I try and eat more. And then the next day I don't even start a diet. So it's like, anyways, all right, we should get into
this. Good times. Okay.
Are we doing like a try, like taste test or?
Yeah, I think we could do a little taste test type thing. So I thought we would do like a wing, like, you know, the wing official taste test. So we've got some, you know, the B-dubs.
This is the favorite among the vlog squad anyways. David loves Buffalo Wild Wings. Did you know that?
Oh, yeah. Yes. It's his church.
He loves that. And I do too. I love it. Okay.
It's blessed. This is Wingstop. So, and we've got some tenders there.
Oh my God, Josh.
I was online ordering, which is dangerous because they were like, hey, before you go.
Yes!
$2.99, want to throw in some spicy tenders? I'm like, I'd be crazy not to.
Oh my God, these are, you did so good. I'm so happy about this.
And
oh my
then,
God.
Just as like the dark horse, because Hooters was right next to Buffalo Wild Wings. Just a couple Hooters wings. Smell that, that smells like Hooters.
Yes, I love the smell of Hooters. I love their wings. I don't think it's a dark horse. I would say just predictions right now, I would say Hooters might be my favorite.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Their wings are like amazing.
Yeah, just, it smells classy.
It smells classy. I mean? Which one do you think is gonna be your favorite?
I don't know, it's a tough one. I got a bunch of different Buffalo Wild Wings. Crimson Crush? Hello.
Oh my God. Wait, what is that, Crimson Crush?
I don't know, but take a ride, buckle up. You know what I mean?
I'm so happy right now.
I mean, only they could think of such an incredible name.
Oh my gosh, this is amazing. What's in here? Oh my God, these are like all so good.
Okay. I got some like atomic, like I got some dumb spicy ones too.
Oh my, are we gonna like die?
Like where you just hate your life. Are you a spicy person?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean I am until I eat it and then I like wanna die. But I have milk just in case it gets too hot. Cause one time I did a Buffalo Wild Wings one where they had the spicy habanero. Have you had that?
No.
It's the spiciest and I almost was gonna die. But like, and I was drinking water and water makes it worse, but I have milk. So now like if you like get so spicy that you can't even like breathe, like you two drink milk and it helps.
Great.
Yeah.
Good. Any reason to drink milk really.
So too, I try and stay away, but you know, with spiciness. But here's the other thing, if we both died together, how iconic would that be?
Yeah, that would be amazing.
Iconic, and honestly, I kind of feel a little scared about that. Like, I thought about that. I always think about this. When someone new comes to my house, I always think about, like, death, because there was an earthquake that just happened. Did you feel it?
No, I was driving. I didn't
feel it. Oh, okay. So there was a big earthquake, and I was thinking, what if Josh, like, Peck died with me? I was like, it would be like when Farrah Fawcett and Michael Jackson died on the same day. No one cared about Farrah Fawcett because it was all about Michael Jackson.
No, stop.
Yeah.
No,
I, like,
we would be so even.
No. If it was in the news, like, it would be like Josh Peck dies, because you're like, you know, mainstream, nobody cares about YouTube, and then like, oh, and this YouTuber was with him.
That is not true. It would be some sort, we would immediate, a Lifetime movie would immediately get put into the works.
Oh, that would be
the
everything.
Death of Trisha and Josh.
Oh, I wish. That would be awesome.
Death by mukbang.
Should I just kill you right now so we can figure it out?
It's totally worth it.
Okay.
Should we like start our palates with something healthy?
Yeah, is that what this is for?
Yeah, just like a celery carrot, like a starter. Like, okay. Do you want a carrot?
Wait, is that why they do it? I've never understood why they do it.
I think it's like a fresh, like a, look at us, we're healthy. Does anyone do healthy mukbangs?
Yeah, but they don't do well. I did one time and it got like 100,000 views.
Stupid. What was it, like friggin' trail mix?
Yeah, that? Eating like vegetables.
Give me a break. Who's got time for all that?
And you know why people like to watch mukbangs too? Is because like if they're on a diet, they want to like watch other people eat. Which,
right.
If I'm on a diet, if I watch someone else eat, I'm going to eat. I don't get that concept, but people do that.
Right. Mm-hmm. Living vicariously through.
Like, you eating it. Or they want to see you be so disgusted. Like after a mukbang, I'm like usually so disgusted with myself. I'm like, I'm so full, I could puke. And then they're like, okay, I won't want to eat.
Right. Yeah, that's smart. But like watching like some of the mukbangs I've seen, and like not to knock like the adorable, you know, like Indonesian 15-year-olds who are like straight up in front of their their camera, like making like 5 cups of noodles. I'm like, this does not look appetizing.
I know. Those do really well though, the noodles one. Just posted one today. Same setup, because I used to always do my setups like this. Well, I got one where I got real close to the camera and did the noodles today. Yeah. I posted it. So we'll see how it does, because everyone does those.
Oh, yeah. It's going to crush.
A million of views later.
I just want to see, like, because I have an idea of your audience, but I bet there's some people that you could never expect that love your videos.
No, yeah.
Like a 45-year-old guy that works at, like, IBM.
No, it was on Real Housewives of Beverly Hills. They were watching it. It was Erica Jane and Lisa Rinna.
Oh, my god.
They were watching it, and they put my video on camera, and then they did the YouTube shout-out.
What?
Yeah, because their daughters were showing it to them. They were, like, in vacation in Japan, and they're like, oh, you got to watch this girl eat. And I was, like, crazy. I was so excited about it.
What an honor.
I was... I was like so excited about it. I was like, ooh.
What about, when's there gonna be a Real Housewives of YouTube?
Oh my god. That would be, it's actually kind of boring, because in real life, YouTubers, like, no offense, but kind of offense, like, YouTubers are kind of boring in real life.
A little bit.
Don't you think?
Well, they're totally addicted to their work.
Yeah, and I think they're all kind of like social recluse people. They don't know how to like really socialize with people outside of YouTube.
Right.
So I think they're kind of like, I don't know, I find a lot of people boring. Maybe that's just me, I don't know.
I get that. I don't know, I've met a lot of real, like, you know, quote unquote, traditionally famous people, and they suck in their
own
way.
Yeah, no, they do. Unless you're like Crispin Glover or something like that, I feel like everyone else is like boring.
Yeah.
So I like eccentric people, like, I think they're really interesting.
Yeah, well, you know, welcome to the vlog squad.
I know, you know, they're pretty interesting. Although I still get awkward. This is what Jason like left right before you. Should we like try something?
Yeah, let's start. Let's get going.
Where okay, should we try one of each, like,
I'd say,
together?
Yeah, let's do that.
Oh, wait, yeah. What is this? It was underneath here. There's like a surprise.
There's like a mix thing. I think these are like the dumb hot ones here. I'll give
those are the dumb hot?
So left is dumb, stupid hot. And this one's like slightly kind of smart, you know, just general education smart. You know what I'm saying?
I love the explanation of it. It's so everything.
You got some souse.
Okay.
I mean, are you a sauce person with the wings?
It depends on the flavor of them. Like, if they're kind of like flavorless, then I'm not so much. Should you try the hot one together?
Yeah.
Okay, let's see how these work.
Let's do this. Okay.
It's not bad.
It's all right.
Is it hot? I feel like these get hotter. Oh, I think they get hotter as you do too.
Oh yeah, it's a slow creep up. I'm being assaulted right now.
This is good though. Yeah. Really white meat. This is so fun.
Right?
Could you imagine when you were like a TV star that one day you'd just be sitting eating on camera? That's like your job.
Yeah, I used to eat alone and get no views.
Oh my god, could you imagine? If they had YouTube back when we were kids, I would have crushed it. I would have been so good.
Oh my god.
Because we were more creative as kids, I feel.
Yeah, it just would have been me alone in my room, like surrounded by my Star Wars bedding.
Were you in LA?
No, I was in New York with a bowl cut with some sick light up sneakers.
Really?
Yeah, me crushing, like, you know, 2 Pizza Hut pizzas to myself.
Really?
Yeah.
How old were you when you did that?
Oh, you know, 5 through 19.
I can crush Pizza Hut pizzas though. I can have two.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's hot.
Yeah, it's hot. Woo! This is real. This is real deal. Holy.
Oh, wow. That was hot. All right. What should we try next? That was Reese's. What's that mean?
Schwitzing, it's like a Jewish word for sweating.
Oh, you're Jewish. Jason told me that. He's like, oh, because I said you were going to pick it up. Oh, so last time we went out, I was like, oh, yeah, he's going to pick it up. I said I'd post me. He's like, oh, well, he's Jewish. He won't post me. And I was like, he's Jewish? I didn't know that. You don't look Jewish at all.
I know. I look kind of like, I don't know what I look
Italian
like.
Italian or Greek.
Italian, yeah. So I did the 23andMe. Have you heard of that?
Yeah, is it sponsored?
This is sponsored by 23andMe. So, like, basically, you spit in a vial, it goes to a lab, they spin your DNA and find out exactly where you come from.
Uh-huh.
Like, hundreds and hundreds of years of your family tree. So I can't wait. I do it and I'm like, oh my God, I can't wait to find out. I'm 10% African American and like I've got, you know, a long lost Filipino cousin down the road. And literally the results come back and it's like 98% Jew.
Stop it.
I'm like, I was like, $200? I could have told you that.
Really?
Yeah, they're like 2% Greek, 98% Jew. I was like,
well, you're 2% Greek. That's exciting.
I guess it's cool.
That's very handsome men are Greek. I'm a little Greek.
Are you?
I have like 10% Greek or 20% because Paytas is Greek.
Oh yeah.
Paytas. Anything with AS or OS is usually very Greek.
Yeah.
Should we try? Do you want the air on? Should we put the air on?
No, I mean, if you want.
Sure. You guys, no, it's
I think it's just
too.
my reaction to the spice.
Was it too spicy for you?
It's I mean, I think I can handle spice ish.
That was spicy.
Yeah.
I mean, that's why I was saying the milk might come in handy. Also, I had the air on earlier, but. All right, so what should we try next? What's in here? What's this little bucket?
Oh, this was like, I was like, this has us written all over it.
I have like all shit on my hands, sorry. I'm like the grossest eater ever.
Okay, here we go, baby. This is a macaroni and cheese.
Whoa.
Fried chicken garlic bread mix.
Oh.
I mean. They should just call this like the 2002 Josh Peck special.
I mean, they rename it after you.
All the best foods in one. Here, wait. I got
forks.
Forks.
I love mac and cheese so much. There's a place called Sweet Chick up the street. Have you been there?
No.
It's like chicken, waffles, mac and cheese, gravy, coleslaw. It's like all that stuff, and they have the best mac and cheese.
Ooh.
Oh, I'm so excited.
Still hot.
You know what? And when I licked the sauce off my fingers, it got even hotter. It was so warm.
Oh, yeah.
So do you have to eat this together? Do you have to eat, like, the mac and cheese with the chicken, or is it separate?
I think it would be, you know, it would be a smart mix.
Yeah, you think? I've never had mac and cheese with chicken.
Oh, yeah.
Let's see.
I mean, what could be bad?
It's actually really good. Wait, what's that? Is bread?
Yeah, I guess it's just, like, kind of garlic bread. I don't know.
So good.
I love it. What if Jason got really jealous of this video?
About doing a mukbang?
He's like, I don't want you mukbanging with other men.
Honestly, he's the worst mukbanger. I did one with David, Jonah, and him. Oh, yeah, get that first bite. Isn't it so good?
Come on.
This is Buffalo Wild Wings?
Yeah.
This is sick. This is actually like my favorite thing so far. This is, I mean, we only had two things, but this is so good.
I want to use it for my birthday cake this year.
When's your birthday?
November.
Oh.
I'm planning your
little. I do the same thing though. My birthday's like a month away and I'm already like planning it. Get to come. You and Paige.
Please.
I always do like big parties every year. That's like so freaking. No, Jason's the worst mukbanger because like me, David, Jonah, and him went through a Burger King drive through twice. Jason didn't get one thing.
Oh.
David had crispy chicken sandwich. Jonah had two Whoppers. We had ice cream and cheesy tots. We were like going at it.
Yeah.
He doesn't like to eat. He's very scared of food. He has a weird food relationship.
Yeah, but then he'll like front and he'll try to be healthy all day and then he'll get home and like pound a bag of cashews and like pop.
Oh,
and
yes.
Like, if you're gonna eat badly, why deal with that?
I know, he does that with candy. Every night he has like probably four Reese's peanut butter cups in the middle of the night.
Yeah.
I wake up and I just see wrappers everywhere.
Did you, whose vlog did you say it on where you know that you have the best relationship ever? Where you woke up and got angry that he didn't wake you up?
Oh yeah, I forget, there's so many vlogs.
There's so many.
I think it might have been yours. Maybe just cut it out. I remember saying it to you and it's like, it's great. We love snacking together.
That's amazing. You're like waking up in the middle of the night and you've got like a little hankering for something sweet and you can turn to your wonderful partner and be like, babe, come on, let's do this.
That's amazing. It is amazing. I'm not gonna lie. That's like the best relationship. He's the best because like his body isn't like perfect and like he doesn't care if my body's perfect. It was like crazy. We were doing a podcast and like we were talking about how he like got catfished by a girl who was like really skinny on Tinder and then he went to go pick her up and she was like literally like 400 pounds. Yeah.
400?
She wanted to like hook up and he was like down. We talked about this on our podcast, but he's like he wanted to hook up with her and then anyways, they were gonna go get drinks. She came to the car and he's like, I gotta go, I can't do this. I'm like,
damn.
Jason, you could have gone out for a drink. drink with her. Even I've given like a sympathy like sex to people. I'm like, oh.
Generous though. You're one in a million. I mean, that is so kind of you.
I feel bad. That's my biggest fear, the guy like seeing me like for the first time being like, nope, I can't do this. Like, that's my biggest fear.
Oh, fuck that guy. If someone did that, oh, you're
that
food.
Was Jason.
That's, I mean, so how did he get catfished? It was an old picture of her, or it was just kind of like...
He didn't know. No, I asked, because he said she was skinny, so either they were old photos, or it might not even have been her. He wasn't sure. He's like, it kind of looked like her, because I can get it. Like, I take really good angles on my Instagram, but, like, you can still tell it's me. He's like, I don't even know if it was her.
Damn.
But she still, like, wanted to, like, hook up when he got in the car, and he's like, no.
He could have been down the clown for
that's
a quick
what I said. Nothing wrong with, have you ever been with big girls?
Have a new experience? Sure.
Have you?
Yeah.
Because your wife's like a beautiful skinny supermodel.
My wife is perfect and I can't believe she settled for me. I definitely married up. But I'm not such a fan of women, the gender.
Yeah.
Before I met my beautiful wife, a life that I'll never ever talk of again except for you followers. Yeah, I mean, I wanted to experience it all. It was like going to like Baskin Robbins and trying to like older, younger, you know, bigger, smaller.
Yeah.
I mean, I just was like, let's just enjoy
it. I'm the same way. I like all sizes, all shapes. It's my fave. What should we try next?
All right, let's see. What do we talk? Should we do the Hooters?
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
I mean, so Hooters, obviously an incredible institution.
I'm so excited about this. Well, you can do the fingers. I was gonna do it, but.
I know, you're doing it so classy. With
Oh, wow. Well, I was like licking my fingers earlier. I'm like, that's gross.
Ooh. You know we were aristocrats.
Yeah.
Tally ho.
You're Jewish, you're classy.
Isn't that right, Nigel?
This might be the best mukbang ever. You're so fucking funny.
This is amazing. These are good.
They're not as great as like Wingstop.
No, they don't have the extra crunch. It's very light breading.
It's very light breading. It's also very kind of squishy meat.
Yeah.
Who are you? Very average.
Yeah, I don't know. I have a soft spot for Hooters wings, but maybe it's just the attire that the waitresses are in. No, I mean, it's just fine.
Yeah, I'm not impressed with that.
Yeah, this isn't my, I'm not knocked out.
We're over that. Okay, let's try maybe, do we try wings at Buffalo Wild Wings yet?
I don't know, I don't think so, yeah.
Should we get that crazy one or?
Ooh, all right, so we got.
Or what's that
oh,
one?
Oh, Crimson
Crush.
Shit, yeah.
We should try this one.
I'll try anything Ooh. With that name. Ooh, baby.
Do you think these are spicy?
I don't, Crimson Crush, what does that say to you?
Oh.
Gross. Yeah. I kind of don't want to try now.
What is it? What is that?
Nope.
Oh my god, what is that?
It's like a sweet, weird...
Oh, wow.
Oh, it's like a weird sweet and sour punch to the face.
Yeah, it's like, it kind of tastes, I hate mustard. It kind of tastes like mustard to me.
Tastes like a Pokemon.
Pokemon?
Like, tastes artificial and...
Yeah, that was like the worst flavor I've ever tasted.
Yeah, just Buffalo Wild Wings. Get your game together, son.
I like the idea, though, of like Crimson Crush or something crazy.
Right.
Okay, what's next?
Oh, wait, I forgot something here. Uh-oh. I just thought this was another one of like, hey, before you go, why not treat yourself to some tenders and onion rings? I was like, I'd be crazy not to.
Safe choice. I mean, right? Chicken fingers are my all-time favorite food.
Are they?
Mm-hmm.
Number one.
I have an album right up there. It says Chicken Fingers and Lipo. That was the name of my album. I love chicken fingers and I love liposuction.
I love chicken tenders too.
They're so good.
What is, I mean, it's kind of a perfect food, right?
It's chicken, but it's also like fried.
Yeah.
You kind of feel a little healthy because it's protein, but it's like, I don't know. It's like such a kid food. I love it.
Did you do that? Like, I assume when I was fat, I would eat chicken tenders and be like, well, it's mostly protein.
Yes.
Yeah. And be like, this is marginal, the breading.
But you know, even when you were bigger, you were never fat. I always hated that on like your show. Cause I was always like, he's not like fat. They always made it seem like you were like fat. You weren't fat. I didn't
I'm
like
pretty
it.
Fat.
No, fat. I've seen some fat. You know what I mean? Like my 600 pound life, but that wasn't you.
That's heavier. Yeah. I mean, I definitely would be afraid to go to the pediatrician.
Really?
Or, yeah. Because they would give me the talk like, Josh, you really got to get your health in order.
Wait, did they ever do that?
Yeah. I was
really?
Like a 12-year-old with high blood pressure.
Really?
I would like walk in. So like with my head hung low and it's like all these like skinny little dickhead kids are like 10 years old.
The worst.
Oh, you're all healthy.
That was me. It's so me. I never had to glow up like you. I'm like, oh, I'm just going to be chubby my whole life.
Oh,
whatever.
Please.
No, but it was hard. Like, growing up like big, did you ever get the, this is my worst favorite, like when you were big, did everyone be like, you have such a good looking face?
Yes.
The worst compliment you can give a fat person, like, your face is so pretty.
I hate that.
I know.
Because it's so like backhanded.
Mm-hmm. Like, oh, if you lost weight, you'd be like really hot.
It's like, it's almost like when you're like, if people are telling you you have so much potential past the age of like 25, you're not.
Yes. But you know what? You are living proof that people tend to be a little more attractive when they lose weight. You know what I mean? That's why I want to do it, to see how hot I could be, but I just can't.
I mean, you're already hot, and I feel like you have, like, I mean, men fawn over you.
Look at my belly. No, I think it's just because I'm easy. What, the thing with chubby girls is they're really easy because they're just, like, so, like, desperate. They're like, ooh, attention. I'm saying this as a chubby girl, by the way. I'm not saying
grateful.
Yeah, I'm just like, give me anything. You know what I mean?
I lost my virginity to a girl that was on the heavier side.
Wait, really? Really?
Yeah.
And she was older than you, huh?
30. I was 18. She was 30.
Were you still big?
I was big-ish. I was probably like 200 and so like 220 and I was not 200, yeah.
But you're tall, so 200 is not bad.
Yeah, but I hadn't been working out or anything, so I definitely wouldn't have wanted to have a photo of me with my shirt off.
Jason's 200 pounds and you're like the same height, right?
Yeah, we're about the same height, but I feel like Jason has like an athletic body.
He does, I would say that too. The hot body.
Yeah, he's got like he has those annoying underwear lines, like near like his hips.
Yeah, no, he does have a good body he always says I don't think he's chubby at all. I think he's skinny. I think he's just like a guy that like if he eats, he has a little belly, but whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But he thinks he's fat. But no, the thing is so when there's two fat people having sex, and I know this too, sometimes mm-hmm. it's a little hard.
Right.
Because it's just a lot happening where you have to like adjust more.
Sure.
So that's why I didn't know if it was hard for you. Were you on top of her?
No, we did everything.
Really?
Oh,
and she
my
was
God.
Big and she got on top of you? Because I used to be self-conscious of that.
We had a great time together. And by the way, just like public service announcement, just speaking from, you know, the male gender, don't ever feel insecure about that. Because mm-hmm. like, we are so glad that you're there.
Yeah, so, oh, I love that.
I used to always say like, I was doing this alone for 7 years. And anytime a girl has decided to join me, I am so grateful that they're there.
I love that you said that. Because girls ask me all the time, like, how are you comfortable having sex? I'm like, to be honest, I'm never uncomfortable because like guys just like want anything, I feel like, you know what I mean? Like they're just, like you said, they're, and so I'm so glad you said that as a guy, because I always say that, I'm like, I'm never self-conscious because no guy has ever been like, your stomach rolls or anything like during sex. Like no one says that ever.
Yeah, that's whack.
And I have some asshole guys and I've never even had guys been like, never once commented on my weight, because like you're having sex with them, they're not going to be like, ew. You know what I mean?
No. They're so stoked.
Yeah, no. And you can get on top. I've only been on top recently and I'm like, I love it so much because I was always so self-conscious, but.
Oh, forget that.
Yeah. Okay. Ooh, what are these?
These also kind of scare me a little bit, but I think there's another.
Yeah, the colors in there scare me. Like, you guys, look at this color. I'm gonna get a little one of these because I don't know about this.
Yeah, right.
What is that one?
This is. Oh, this doesn't even have a name on it.
Oh, that's scary.
That's mystery.
Mystery.
That's nuclear orange.
Oh, that is really orange. I think the orange. This is Parmesan garlic. Ugh. That kind of sounds like a bad time. Like, look at the. It looks, the sauce looks questionable.
Right,
okay, let's just try it.
Let's see here.
Hmm.
I'm not mad at it.
It tastes like a garlic knot.
I'm not stoked at it.
No.
I'd rather have a garlic knot.
Yeah. You know? With the bread.
I mean, shit.
Yeah, it's kind of whatever.
What do we got over there? This is honey barbecue.
Whoa, that's the home run amongst everybody. When
is
we
it?
Go out to Buffalo Wild Wings, I feel like Your the group, you know, they all get those.
Mm.
That's Jason's choice. I know Aaron gets that.
Really?
David gets it. Everyone loves those. Those are the classic. Have you had them?
I don't think so.
Oh, these are really good.
I'm excited if these are endorsed by the vlog squad.
Are you in that? I don't know who's in it.
I don't know. I think I'm in it as much as you are. Like, I think we're like the fringe squad.
That's what I said. I'm like, I'm not in it, and Jason gives you. I'm like, no, I'm kind of like the add-on. I'm like the plus one that comes around sometimes.
Probably better that way.
That's what I say too.
Screw it.
I've never been in a squad.
We start our own squad.
Okay. What's it gonna be?
Chicken tenders.
We're just going with anybody.
Chicken finger fam.
Love that.
Yeah, I would. I'm down for that.
We get merch, chicken finger fam.
Oh yeah.
How do you think about these?
Not bad.
Really, you don't love? I love these.
It's good. I mean, I get it. I think I understand what it's kind of the perfect thing.
Mm-hmm.
Sweet, not spicy, fried. It's good.
I think it's crunchy.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I can hear it crunch. Mmm. I love those so much.
This mukbang is just thriving. Now I understand why you do it so much.
It's so fun.
I mean, people love it. Get to have a nice big lunch.
Did you eat today?
No.
Yeah.
I have a kombucha before I got here.
What's that?
You ever have that?
Mm-mm.
It's those teas, the fermented teas that are like supposed to be good for your stomach and probiotics. And
yeah, that's before
like,
this.
Yeah, I was like, let me line my stomach with some healthy kind of things.
When do you binge? Do you binge like this ever?
I don't know. I eat dessert every day.
What do you eat?
In some form. Like, it's not some OD. Like, sometimes I'll go to Yogurtland and be like, ba-da-ba-da-ba. Like, you know.
That's yogurt, though. That's healthy.
Bring me back to the old me. Bring me back to the old me. Ga-ga-ga-ga.
Oh, my God. I can see you doing that, too.
And then I'm just, like, sprinkling, like, Oreo crumbs. Sprinkles.
That sounds delicious right now. Oreo crumb frozen yogurt.
So good. But I always like I'm weird, like I'm an old man with some shit, like you'll get in my car and you'll look in like the little cup holder and it'll just be a bag of peanut M&Ms.
Oh.
And I'll just drive around and munch those all day.
That's our go-to at the movie. So again, another perfect example, when we saw 50 Shades of Grey, I got the M&Ms because we had just eaten sushi. So I'm like, I'm gonna get M&Ms, peanut M&Ms. I offer him the whole movie. You want some? No, can't have any. At the end of the credits, when it's time to go, he's over there just trying to get as many as he can in his mouth. I'm like, Jason, do you want to take those with us? No, I just want to eat them. I'm like, why would you eat them through the movie? Why would you want to take it with us? He has to like sneak it in, but it's not sneaking because your body knows it's going in your mouth.
Yeah, I can't take that.
It's weird. I have food issues too, but he's got issues, you know. Anyways, should we try it? What else?
How about a fried pickle in there?
A fried pickle?
Have you ever done that?
No, what's it taste like?
Well, you can imagine.
Mmm.
It's kind of a different thing.
Mm, the thing with fried vegetables like zucchini and stuff, it's still like a vegetable.
Right.
So I mean, it's good, but why eat a vegetable if you're gonna have like a fried?
Yeah, I agree.
I don't hate them.
It's all right.
It's all right.
You did it. You live there. You can live with the Crimson Crush, you son of a bitch.
Bye.
No need for you.
What do you think is the spiciest? Should we try them?
Okay.
Did we already have the spicy one?
Where's the wild? Okay.
This is that wild?
Yeah, this is boneless. Like, the sticker should just say, you.
You're gonna die.
Yeah.
That if we died.
Oh my God, look at that.
Oh.
That, I mean, that just looks like the color of Satan's tongue. Oh, dear.
Wow, this looks amazing.
I'm already sweating.
Oh yeah, because it's fucking, it's hot. Like this food is hot as balls.
Now, Buffalo Wild Wings is a popular mukbang I've seen.
Yeah,
like,
oh yeah.
People do it.
Huge, I did one. I ordered like 40 wings and ate them all.
No.
Yeah. I'm excited, but I didn't do it since last year, so I'll try this. I haven't tried that wild ones.
And you did nuggets too, right? Didn't you do like a 50 piece nugget?
100.
No.
100 nuggets, mm-hmm. With my sister.
Unbelievable. Yeah. Oh, so you guys shared?
No, we just got 100.
And she finished
you? It was who could eat it the fastest, so I won.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
She knocked it out though?
No. She stopped because it's really greasy. It's not even the food, it's just like the grease in your stomach. How do you feel about this? Mm-hmm. I don't think it's that bad.
I'm waiting.
Yeah, like is it gonna do an after kick?
Yeah, this is gonna be a punch to the face. It's coming, I can tell.
Mm-hmm. I don't think I haven't swallowed it now.
As did I. It's not here yet. It doesn't feel great.
It's not as hot as these. These were like crazy. No.
Wingstop hates you.
Yeah, that was
like, you're gonna friggin' pay for this.
That wasn't so intense. I mean, it is spicy, but.
You ain't shit, son.
Bye.
Got it like that, my dude. Woo! Yeah, a little spicy.
I don't know, that wasn't terrible to me.
Well, back to what we were talking about before, what is your background? Because my wife and I, Paige, always wonder what, like, so you're a little Greek.
Mm-hmm. Well, my dad's 100% Hungarian. Yes. And then my mom's the mix of, like, German, Greek.
Right.
I think it's just German, Greek, Hungarian.
And you have one sister?
One sister and one brother.
And is your sister, like, as fly as you, like, where she's all done up and stuff?
Oh, yeah. She's, like, way more glamorous. She's, like, really fit and, like, works out, eats healthy. But, like, and she has big boobs, like, big boobs and...
What are you trying to prove?
No, she definitely is, but... And she'll say this, too. Like, she definitely, I think, wins with, like, stunner, right? For sure. But, like, definitely have a better personality. Like, she,
really?
She knows that. She's, like, Trish is the fun one. I'm the outgoing one. I'm the one that people like gravitate towards. Mm. But she's got a sick body, so that'll always be like, oh, I wish I had that.
Well, I find that personality is like grown.
Yeah.
You know, like it's nurtured. It's born out of like necessity.
Yeah.
And whenever I see a really like hot dude, like really good looking guy, and he's trying to be super funny, I sometimes want to say, there's a good chance I'm funnier than you. And it's not, like, I would trade it in a second to have your midsection.
You would? You would trade that? I wouldn't. As a girl with a guy, for a guy, like, I always take personality over body, always.
Really?
I've dated people with, like, six packs, like, dancers, and they're so boring, like, all that stuff. Guys who are funny, like, that's why I'm so in love with Jason. He's like, I don't get why you love me so much. I'm like, because you're, like, so funny. Like, I've never had someone like that.
Funny.
He said you were the funniest of the group, because I said, I don't know, I'm nervous, I don't want to do this with Josh, like, I feel like I'm not funny, and, like, he's like, don't worry, Josh is, like, the funniest of anybody, he'll make it good. I was like, okay, he said you were the funniest. Yeah,
that's
you are.
So nice.
You are, and every time I see you, I always, like, the first couple times I saw you, I was always, like, so nervous, I was like, oh my god, he's so funny, and I'm so, like, not, and, like, it was, I don't know, I get nervous around funny people.
No way.
Because I'm not funny.
No, you are a friggin' powerhouse.
Really?
Here. Oh, please, come in here, I felt like in such safe hands.
Yeah.
Triggered.
Anyways.
So I think we're agreeing that Wingstop is the winner, right?
I think I'm like hacking and dying over here because there's so much sauces in my mouth.
Oh my god.
I think I mean, I would say that for me, I would say, as far as taste, this thing kills it.
Yeah.
For sure.
Incredible.
But this has the hottest wings. I think it has the best meat. The best white meat.
I would say so.
Which one did you pick up first? Maybe that has something to do with it.
I picked up this last, actually. The
Wingstop? Maybe that's why it's better, though, because it was, like, really fresh and hot.
That's true.
Because this is, I would have said maybe even Buffalo Wild Wings before. Wait, maybe I just never eat Wingstop.
I don't know what it, I mean, let me tell you, the experience at all three of these places was wonderful. I took a selfie with each person at the counter.
Stop it. No, you didn't.
So thank you all for making me feel like I am a celebrity again.
Did they ask you or did you ask them for the selfie?
Both.
I didn't know if like, you took it just to like, say, I'm here, or like...
No. I'm like, here, you want to summon with me, don't you?
Oh, they recognize you.
Yeah.
I love that.
I mean, Buffalo Wild Wings employees, like 20-year-old kids, that's my fan base.
You are like this cult thing. Like, even David at 21, I'm like, he's like, I love Drake and Josh. I'm like, that was the one I was a kid. Like, how do you know that? Maybe it gets reruns?
Yeah, reruns.
That you get no money from.
Thanks, Nickelodeon.
Now you're doing eating shows.
Well, I think this has been a really successful mukbang.
Yeah, this is great.
I feel really good about it.
I love it. You are the best mukbanger because you do a good combination of eating and talking.
Thank you for taking my mukbang virginity.
Oh my god, you lose all your virginity to chubby girls.